Hi guys, welcome to our video 3.4, Types of Chemical Reactions. There's a handful of chemical reaction types that we're gonna have to memorize. But first, we're gonna just talk a little bit about chemical equations. Now, chemical reactions are written out as chemical equations. All right, for example, if we take carbon plus oxygen, put them together as a compound, we get carbon dioxide. And it's gonna be written out like this. C for carbon, O2, because oxygen is a Brinkelhoff, it's always diatomic in nature, yield CO2. And then these other little markings, the little S means it's a solid, so solid carbon. L would be a liquid. G is the gas, so solid carbon plus oxygen gas makes carbon dioxide, which is a gas. And then we'll sometimes see AQ, as we talked about, means aqueous or dissolved in water. Okay, so first type of reaction we're going to talk about is synthesis, and it's from the Greek word synthesis, I'm sure I'm mispronouncing that, which means to place together. And in a synthesis reaction, two or more elements or compounds combine to form one product. Okay, so we have here on the left our two reactants, so our reactants on the left, and our product on the right. So we have two things being put together to form one. Iron and sulfur make iron sulfide. And the general form of a synthesis reaction, we'll say, is X plus Y yields XY. Two things on the left, one on the right. Some books, like even the your textbook for the course, will call these a combination reaction. Means the same thing, but we're going to use synthesis. Next one you need to know about is decomposition. Now, you should remember from biology class, right? What do decomposers do? Right, they break things down. So it's going to be the opposite of synthesis. And in a decomp or decomposition reaction, one compound breaks down into two or more products. So it's just the opposite of before, right? Iron sulfide breaks down into iron and sulfur. The general formula is just the flip side, right? Synthesis was X plus Y yields XY. And this is just the opposite. XY yields X plus Y. There's one on the left and two on the right. Okay. Next one I'm going to talk about is what's called single replacement. In a single replacement reaction, a more reactive element replaces a less reactive one in a compound. Okay, so here we have magnesium metal and iron sulfate. And the magnesium is more reactive than the iron, so it kicks out the iron, says get out, and we end up with magnesium sulfate and iron by itself, right? The more reactive kicked out the less reactive. Now, how do you know what's more and less reactive? Well, you go back to the activity series. Oh, sorry. The general formula, right? X plus YZ yields XZ plus Y. The X kicks out the Y, so the Y is now by itself, and the X combines with the Z, and we get XZ. All right, going back to what I started to say a moment ago, how do you know what's more reactive? Well, if you look on Table J, the activity series, the higher, and it tells you up here, most active on top, or least active on top. So something higher will replace something lower. So if we look, right, here's magnesium, and here's iron. The magnesium is higher than the iron, so it kicks it out. The next is a double replacement. And that's where an element in one compound swaps places with an element in the other. Right? They swap, they trade places. So we can see here that initially we have barium nitrate and sodium sulfate. In the products, we have barium sulfate, right? The barium took the place of the sodium. Oop. and sodium nitrate. The sodium went back and took the place of the barium. They just traded places. General formula, XY plus WZ yields XZ plus WY. Right, the X kicks out the W, and the W kicks out the X, so we end up with XZ and WY. Another very common one is combustion. And if you think about it, you know what this means. Right? When we talk about combustion, what are we talking about? Well, we're talking about something burning. And generally, a hydrocarbon, which is a certain, you know, C something, H something, it can be CH4, C2H6, etc., etc., burns, but what do you have to have fire? Oxygen, right? And that you know. The whole reason why they taught you stop, drop, and roll is you're smothering the fire by removing oxygen from it. So in order to have fire, you have to have oxygen. So hydrocarbon burns in oxygen, and the products are carbon dioxide and water. Believe it or not, burning something creates water. So you need to be able to recognize a combustion reaction. We have our hydrocarbons and oxygen, and the products are carbon dioxide and water. And for here, the general one is almost the same as specific combustion reactions. Some type of hydrocarbon in the presence of oxygen makes carbon dioxide and water. All right, there's a few other kinds that we're going to learn about over the next few units. We don't have to have these types of reactions memorized now. I just thought I'd kind of introduce them to you. One kind is a neutralization reaction. It's a special kind of double replacement reaction where an acid reacts with a base and they make a salt and water. The next two aren't specific types of reactions, but just some other important things about them. Reactions can be exothermic in that they give off energy, they give off heat energy, and that'll be written with plus heat on the product side. So if it's giving off heat energy, heat is a product, right? When you burn a candle, when you have fire, boy, this is the worst candle. No, there you go. Pretend this is fire. It gives off heat. That's exothermic. So heat is a product. Endothermic, absorb heat energy. If you think of like those chemical ice pack things, where it's a plastic pack, you smack it, mix up the chemicals, and it gets really, really cold, they're going to absorb heat, right? They're really cold because they're absorbing heat from the environment. In that case, heat is a reactant. Chemical reactions can be reversible. They can go in the both directions at the same time. So you can have X plus Y making XY, and at the same time that that's happening, the XY is constantly breaking down into X and Y. And others that we're going to learn later in the year is our oxidation and reduction reactions, which are dealing with the loss and gain of electrons. But like I said, each one of these are going to be in some upcoming units. All right, question time. So you need to be able to, with each of these, label them as synthesis, decomposition, single replacement, double replacement, or combustion reactions. All right, so synthesis, if we have X plus Y making XY, we have two things on the left, one on the right, that's a synthesis. A single replacement, it's one thing by itself here. Here it's in a compound. The other thing that's by itself on the product side was part of a compound on the reactant side. The silver here kicks out the gold, and we end up with silver chloride and gold by itself. So that would be a single replacement. All right, take a look at the rest. You should be able to do these. And I will see you guys in school.